The following is an EWTN special presentation.
Welcome to the Cathedral of St. John the Baptist in Turin, Italy. These are live prayer for an extraordinary exhibition of the Shroud of Turin, so that faithful across the world might contemplate the man in the shroud that bears all the signs of the Passion of Christ. It's thought to be the burial cloth of Christ. It's all happening on Holy Saturday, when the Church celebrates, remembers, the day that Jesus spent in the tomb in the Holy Sepulchre. Archbishop Cesare Nosiglia of Turin is going to a ceremony where we'll see an unveiling of the Shroud of Turin, a special, extraordinary exposition. Few people are present, as you can see there, due to coronavirus concerns. The entire nation of Italy is actually on lockdown, just like many other parts of the world. There are no public leaders. Archbishop decided to make this exposition possible by way of the media. Expositions of the Shroud of Turin do not take place very often. The last was in 2015, anniversary of 200 years since the birth of St. John Bosco. And for that occasion, Pope Francis made the trip up to Turin and actually was there to also venerate the Shroud in person. According to tradition, actually, the presence of the Shroud in the Cathedral of Turin dates back to 1576, after the plague had swept through Europe. Milan's archbishop at the time, St. Charles Borromeo, wanted to make a pilgrimage up to France to visit the Shroud, and instead it was brought to Turin, where it remains today. I start to prepare ourselves for this liturgy that's led by Archbishop Cesare Nosiglia, the Archbishop of Turin, Italy. A beautiful hymn being sung now by a small choir there in the cathedral called Lord's Sweet Face. Lord's Sweet Face of Pain and Sorrow, O Face Full of Light, Struck by Love, Wrapped in Death, You lost Yourself for Us. Welcome our cry, O Savior of ours. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord who guides our hearts in the love and patience of Christ be with you all. And with your spirit. Brothers and sisters, on this holy Thursday, the day of repose in the sepulchre of the Lord, the day of waiting for his resurrection, we unite ourselves to the cry of all of humanity that waits to be liberated from the pandemic that kills and takes life. In this time of waiting, the meek and humble face of the Lord comes to us, impressed on the shroud, that we keep as a precious treasure in our city and our nation. Let us prepare the eyes of our hearts for the vision of his face and listen to his word.
Quando le tenebre invadono le nostre vie, fa splendere la tua luce.
When darkness invades our paths, make your light shine.
Quando il dubbio oscura la nostra speranza, fa splendere la tua luce.
When doubt darkens our hope, make your light shine.
Quando la fatica rallenta il cammino, fa splendere la tua luce.
When our struggles slow the path, make your light shine.
Preghiamo. O Padre, che
let us pray. O Father, who glorified your Son, Jesus Christ, in his blessed passion, and established him Lord in his resurrection from the dead, grant to us who venerate his image, represented in the holy shroud, the grace to contemplate his glorious face. He is God and lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit forever and ever.
Amen.
We're going to begin our prayer before the Synod, putting ourselves in a perspective of listening to Pope Francis' message.
All'incontro con la sindone, per chiedere al Signore di liberarci dall'epidemia che semina morte e sofferenza in tutto il mondo. A Sua Eccellenza Reverendissima Monsignor Cesare Nosiglia.
To His Reverend Excellency Monsignor Cesare Nosiglia, Archbishop of Turin and Bishop of Susa, I've learned, dear brother, that this coming Saturday you will preside at a celebration in the chapel that holds the Holy Shroud, which will be made specially visible to all those who participate in prayer through the means of social communication. I wish to express to you my warm appreciation of this gesture, which responds to the request of God's faithful people, sorely tried by the coronavirus pandemic.
Anch'io alla vostra supplica, rivolgendo lo sguardo all'uomo della sindone, nel quale riconosciamo.
I too join in your supplication, turning my gaze to the man of the shroud, in whom we recognize the features of the servant of the Lord that Jesus realized in his passion. A man of suffering and familiar with pain. Surely he took up our pain and bore our suffering. But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed. In the face of the man of the shroud, we also see the faces of so many sick brothers and sisters, especially of those who are most alone and least cared for, but also all the victims of wars and violence, of slavery and persecution. As Christians, in the light of the Scriptures, we contemplate in this cloth the icon of the Lord Jesus crucified, dead and risen again. To him we entrust ourselves, in him we confide. Jesus gives us the strength to face every trial with faith, with hope, and with love, in the certainty that the Father always listens to his children who cry to him. and saves them.
Dear
confrère and all of you, dear brothers and sisters who participate through the media in the prayer before the shroud, let us live these days in intimate union with the passion of Christ, to experience the grace and the joy of his resurrection. I bless your excellency, the Church of Turin, and all of you, especially the sick and the suffering, and those who care for them. May the Lord grant you all peace and mercy. Happy Easter. Rome, St. John Lateran, the 9th of April, 2020. Fraternally, Francis. So Archbishop Cesare Nosiglia now moving there towards the chapel that holds the case where the Holy Shroud is kept.
Signore Gesù, noi ti rendiamo grazie perché hai preso su di te.
Lord Jesus, we give you thanks because you've taken the sorrows from every time and every man onto yourself. Your face, your hands and your feet, your side and all of your body are for us a source of hope, because love penetrated the extreme darkness of evil and sorrow. Give us the light of faith. Give us the strength of love. Grant us to hear your voice that calls us to bear witness to the world your victory over sin and death. You who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Contempliamo il tuo volto nella tua maestà dolorosa.
Lord, we contemplate your face in your sorrowful majesty. Your closed eyes speak of a tranquil sorrow that has stopped suffering.
I segni di una sofferenza grande.
The signs of great suffering. Swelling and wounds, blood on your cheeks and in your hair, signs of fractures on your nose and split lips. Remind us of the words of Isaiah. He had no majestic bearing to catch our eye, no beauty to draw us to him. He was spurned and avoided by men, a man of suffering, knowing pain.
Eppure questo volto non comunica soltanto.
And yet this face doesn't only communicate sorrow, but love.
è il ritratto
più espressivo is shown more expressive con ogni of solidarity with every human sorrow,
più autentico della
the most authentic mirror of the beauty of the Father.
Contempliamo le tue mani, Signore. Quelle
mani contemplate your hands, O Lord.
Del lavoro, rese forti negli
those great and able hands for working, made strong in the years of Nazareth. Those delicate and attentive hands, made tender by the love of your mother.
Le tue mani. Che hanno spalmato gli
your hands that you laid on the eyes of the blind man so that he might regain his sight.
Che hanno
your hands that broke the bread
il vino nell'ultima cena
and brought the wine during the Last Supper so that your disciples might communicate the gift of your life.
Sono raccolte sul corpo sepolto.
Are now gathered atop your buried body.
Sembrano dire come è scritto nel.
And seem to say, as is written in the Gospel of John.
È compiuto.
It is finished.
Ai discepoli parlano della verità eterna del tuo.
To your disciples, they speak of the eternal truth of your love.
Per difendersi e
that didn't close your fists to defend yourself and condemn, but you kept them open together with your arms
e per sempre.
For everyone and forever.
Contempliamo il tuo cuore trafitto, Signore Gesù. Il tuo corpo è già penetrato nel mistero della morte, ma dal tuo fianco squarciato il tuo cuore ha ancora qualcosa da donare. Come racconta il Vangelo di Giovanni, vedendo che era già morto, uno dei soldati con una lancia gli colpì il fianco e subito ne uscì sangue e acqua. Quella macchia abbondante di sangue vicina al costato parla del tuo amore che genera vita. Come dal costato del primo Adamo è stata tratta Eva, così dal tuo costato dormiente sulla croce è scaturito il mirabile sacramento di tutta la Chiesa.
Dal Vangelo secondo Luca. Era verso mezzogiorno, quando il sole si eclissò e si fece buio su tutta la terra fino alle 3 del pomeriggio. Il velo del Tempio si squarciò nel mezzo. Gesù, gridando a gran voce, disse: «Padre, nelle tue mani consegno il mio spirito». Detto questo, spirò. C'era un uomo di nome Giuseppe, membro del Sinedrio, persona buona e giusta. Non aveva aderito alla decisione e all'operato degli altri.
In the Gospel according to Luke, it was now about noon and darkness came over the whole land until 3 in the afternoon because of an eclipse of the sun. Then the veil of the temple was torn down the middle. Jesus cried out in a loud voice, "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." And when he had said this, he breathed his last. Now there was a virtuous and righteous man named Joseph, who, though he was a member of the council, had not consented to their plan of action. He came from the Jewish town of Arimathea and was awaiting the kingdom of God. He went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. After he had taken the body down, he wrapped it in a linen cloth and laid him in a rock-hewn tomb in which no one had yet been buried. The word of the Lord.
Cari fratelli e sorelle,
dear brothers and sisters, the shroud is the icon of Holy Saturday, of this day.
In attesa dell'evento stupendo e atteso della sua risurrezione, che inonda di luce la notte.
There at the Holy Sepulchre, there would have been a great expectation for the resurrection of the Lord and for the Holy Easter. Also today, we contemplate the face and the wounds of the dead Christ, but with hope in our hearts that very soon, this very evening, in our vigil, the announcement of his victory over death. In these difficult and complex times, many other believers no longer have eyes to see, to recognize the Lord beside them, who is the first source of hope and strength, to confront all of this with courage. This epidemic that disseminates death, there are so many concerns of the people who have tested positive for coronavirus. The shroud aids us to go beyond all of these travails and to see a message of death and life together in the events of Christ and his passion. And this opens our hearts and our minds in the most intimate part of us, the faith and a hope. Looking at this sacred shroud, we see the test of the greatest love in this unique cloth, which differentiates itself from so many others that have been made by human hands. Together with the contemplation that accompanies our prayer, there's a particular intensity through this mirror of the Gospels that John Paul II called it. You can see how much of the Gospel is revealed through the passion and death of Christ. It's a mirror also of ourselves, we who are called to see in the shroud the fullness of our humanity.
e per tutta l'umanità. Sì.
And to see the love that God has for each of us and for all of humanity. There have been great floods of people who have come through here through to see the Synod, the Shroud.
Del suo affetto misericordioso, della sua comprensione amorosa e solidale,
in his mercy,
e che vuole sentirsi amata da un gesto di predilezione, accolta da un abbraccio affettuoso che rincuora e unisce. Allora,
he who wishes to feel our love,
possiamo ben dire che il nostro non è un semplice osservare la sindone.
Ours is not just a simple observation of the Synod, of the Shroud, but it's allowing ourselves to be seen by the face of God with his eyes closed, of a dead man. But curiously, he looks at us and he speaks to us in silence to help us to understand the great suffering that he had to suffer because of our sins, and to liberate ourselves from sin and death. How is this possible? How is it that the faithful wishes to look and gaze at this man who has been crucified? Because we look to Jesus Christ who died and rose again. The image that's impressed on this shroud speaks to our hearts and helps us to go up the Mount of Calvary.
Nel silenzio eloquente dell'amore e lasciarci raggiungere da questo sguardo che non cerca i nostri occhi, ma
helps us to be sought out by this gaze that doesn't just seek our eyes but our hearts.
La parola unica e definitiva di Dio, l'amore fatto uomo incarnato nella nostra storia. L'amore misericordioso.
Archbishop Nosilia is saying that this is the love in person that's depicted in the Shroud.
Questo volto sfigurato ci ha ricordato ancora.
This disfigured face reminds us, said the Pope. It looks like so many of the faces of our sick brothers and sisters, especially those who are most alone, but also victims of wars and violence and slavery and persecution.
And
the face in the Shroud also communicates a great peace. This tortured body speaks of majesty. It communicates an energy, a powerful energy.
Non perdere la speranza.
That says, trust, don't lose hope, the force of the love of God, the power of the risen one, is victorious over everything, even death. The Shroud invites us to welcome this announcement, this proclamation,
quella carità che suscita speranza nel cuore dei poveri e di chiunque l'accoglie con fede.
I Vangeli ci narrano di donne che vanno al sepolcro, portando.
The Gospels speak to us of women who go to the sepulchre, bringing with them perfumed oils, scented oils for his burial. They're gestures of affection and piety that become a prophecy of life and victory. The body of the Lord is perfume that has been spread across the wood of the cross and in the hearts of his disciples. And we see symbolically perfumed oil being placed there before the Shroud. As the choir sings, "Face of light, of victory and freedom, you traced the paths of life. With the cross, you break the barriers of death. Son of God, have mercy on us."
Dio onnipotente ed eterno, dal quale tutto
omnipotent and eternal God, from which all of the universe receives energy, existence and life, we come to you to invoke your mercy, because today we are still experiencing the fragility of the human condition in the experience of this viral pandemic. We believe that it is you to guide the course of the history of man, and that your love can change our destiny for the better, whatever our human condition may be. For this, we entrust to you the sick and their families, that the paschal mystery of your Son may give them salvation and relief. To your love that doesn't abandon, we entrust all of the dead of these days in every nation of the world. Help each member of society to carry out his role, reinforcing the spirit of mutual solidarity. Support the doctors and the health workers, the educators and the social workers in the fulfillment of their service. You who are comfort in the struggles and support in weakness, through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary and of all holy doctors and healers, keep every evil away from us. Liberate us from this epidemic that is hitting us, so that we may be serene again in our usual occupations and praise and thank you with renewed hearts. In you we trust, and to you we raise our supplication, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
La benedizione del Signore sia sempre.
The blessing of the Lord be always with you, and accompany us in the expectation of celebrating in the joy of the resurrection of the Lord. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Thus concludes this extraordinary moment of exposition of the Shroud of Turin, the moment of contemplation of the face of Christ represented in the Shroud, believed to be a cloth that accompanied Christ in the tomb, and on this Holy Saturday in particular, a reminder that Christ at Easter, tomorrow, this evening, will be remembered as well for his resurrection. This has been a live production from the Cathedral of Turin, the Cathedral of St. John the Baptist, brought to you by EWTN. In these times of struggle for so many, where we join in prayer for those who are sick and also to support those who are spending their lives to help people during this great crisis in the world. We look to the face of Christ, as Archbishop Cesare Nosilia said, for solace and for comfort, but also signing off. This is Alan Holdren, EWTN Vatican Bureau Chief, on behalf of all of us from EWTN. Prayers for all of you this Easter season.
Sì, sì.